Happy Sunday, everybody. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, Reed. Hello, Lifu. Welcome in, welcome in. I hope you all have been having a wonderful weekend so far. My weekend has been great. Today we are playing Indigo Park. From what I heard, this is a horror game, so awesome. The goal today is to beat the entire chapter in one sitting. Can we do it? I don't know. Lifu, when I saw your VOD, you lasted around 2 hours to beat the entire campaign, so hopefully it shouldn't be too hard to do. But yeah, I know nothing about this game. It seems to be one of the new indie horrors that have been popping up, you know, similar to Five Nights at Freddy's, Bendy and the Ink Machine, that kind of whole thing. Kodiak loves horror. I do love horror. I like being scared. I don't like Five Nights at Freddy's, like the original ones, because they jump scare me and I don't like jump scares, but I do appreciate good horror. Which is why I'm more interested in playing Security Breach, because Security Breach doesn't just rely on jump scares. There's actually like a sense of horror in it where you're actually avoiding getting caught. So yeah, I like that. There's a good mix of everything in Security Breach. Actually, now that I think about it, I probably should have gotten it when it was on sale. Oh, well. Guess I won't be playing that for a while. But yeah. We're going to be playing it. We're going to be playing some Indigo Park. I have no idea if this is going to be a good game or not. But yeah. It's very similar to Poppy's Playtime. I don't know if that's still ongoing or not. But I know... like, that's kind of like the new wave of horror coming in, of mascot horror. I think that's what they've been calling it now. Yeah, with Poppy's Playtime. So this hopefully is a good first step to a new franchise. Don't worry, this game doesn't go crazy with jump scares. Oh, thank goodness. Thank goodness. I was on the title screen and I already saw a freaky-ass bird looking at me, so I can't wait to be chased by that. Is that a Kodiak My Eye Spy? Hello, Hoshi! Hello, you wonderful hamster, you. Yes, it is me. Your king summons you from beyond the multiverse. I'm here to venture into a new world. I also have to record that line for you, Hoshi. I didn't forget. I got you. But yeah, I hope you all have been well. We're going to jump right into the game right now and see what we have in store for us. It's park day, chat. Park day. I hope you're all excited for the park. Because I'm not. Oh, here we go. Here it is. Here's the park day. 3, 2, 1. There it is. Hopefully the audio was okay. Hopefully everything sounds good. There we go. Hello, Michi. Oh, Michi, you're going to have to leave immediately now that you're here. It's a horror game. We all get to go to the park with a super brave bear. Exactly! I'm gonna be like Garagura, you know? Like, the jump scare's gonna happen, and she's just gonna be, like, stoic, like... has no effect on me. Is that another horror? Yeah, Michi. So you're either gonna have to stick with us, or you're gonna have to bow out. I'd rather you stay, though. Come on, Michi, stay for the horror. It'll be a fun time at the park. Look at that bird in the background. It's gonna be so nice. Come on, stick with us. Okay. I start game now. Oh, yeah, new game. No. It's okay. Oh, come on, we're all here together. Okay. New game. I think this is a okay volume. Yeah, I think this is a good volume. If the game is too loud, please let me know. Because I did an audio test today, so I think this is a good volume. New game. Are you sure you want to start a new game? This will overwrite your previous save data. Yes. Isaac Indigo's Indigo Park. I was scared of BioShock.
Journey to this newfound paradise, we welcome you. Indigo Park offers a slice of the American dream to call your own.
Oh, the American dream.
Echoes of days gone are brought back to life as a new generation captures a glimpse of the exciting potential of tomorrow. Indigo Park.
God, you could tell they dubbed over that video.
That gave rise to our great
the lips do not match.
Here you embark on the journey of a lifetime, a place of
yeah, good America. Guns and violence.
What's going on? Oh, look, it's the bird. Mom's favorite. Oh, is he on Twitch? Learn with them. Honestly, I think this is probably going to be way worse than BioShock Michi. But you should totally stay. Oh, are we an influencer trying to break into the park? Oh, that's perfect. That's perfect. We are the Logan Paul breaking into this place. Watch me break in here and make like a unsolicited video that gets everyone upset at me. Great lurk. Aw, and she's gone. Damn. Chapter 1, Birds of a Feather. We flock together, Michi. Michi. Objective, find a way into the park. We're a streamer. Oh, wait a minute. Ew. Oh, great. It's plain. Ugh. What are these controls called? Not tank controls. They're invert axis on? I think this is it. Please. Damn it. Okay, that's not it. Flight controls. I hate flight controls with a burning passion of a thousand suns. So much. My brain is happy. Flight controls mess with my brain so hard. Oh no, the rat. Who are you calling a rat? Hi, Zeph. Welcome in. Bye, Zeph. Thank you for coming in. They can't capture us. Scatter. Huh. I'm not a rat. I'm a bear. Can you not obviously tell? Oh, the screen's broken. Oh, what is this? Visit an information kiosk to learn more. Hey, let me in. Alright, so I gotta sneak into this place. Ah, okay. Nice. Anything over here? Nope, just trash. Be a ruin like me. No, I know what I am. Not to say you're not cute, Hoshi.
Hi there, and welcome to Indigo Park! The world's most innovative and engaging family fun experience! Jump into the world of your favorite character. Wait, you're our first guest in 2,920 days, 4 hours, 23 minutes, and 38 seconds.
Oh, why do you keep track of that, huh?
Congratulations! I'm Rambly, Rambly the Raccoon. And it's my job to make sure your experience here at Indigo Park is the most fun it can be.
Just hop on over to the registration center to your left, where our friendly assistant will help you begin your adventure in the park.
Oh, again, an assistant? Fantastic. Ooh, a chair.
Hi, I'm Rambly, Rambly the Raccoon, and it's my job to make sure your experience here at Indigo Park is registered. Let me just get a good look at you.
Hello.
Don't seem to have your face in our guest list. Is this your first time here at the park?
Or mm-hmm.
Did you just get plastic surgery?
No, I'm a yokai.
It's Rambly Tuesday, so you qualify for a big discount on your visit. Just follow me to the main gate. Ooh, I can't wait for you to see everything Indigo Park has to offer.
I don't do great with horror, so I'm gonna lurk. Have fun, though. Hey, not the ninja. It is absolutely fine. I know horror isn't everyone's thing, but I appreciate the lurk. Okay, so I have to go... Was it here? Can I go through the front door now?
What's the holdup? The gate is open. Head on into the entryway. Hold on. My mistake. The gate is not open. There seems to be an error message being sent from the gate's power unit. Lucky you! You get to be the first person to try our turn on the generator mini rambly venture. Have fun!
Oh. I get to turn on generators. This is a real horror game now. Yeah, only Michi has to stay. Only Michi stays. Alright, so where's the generator? It shouldn't be too hard to find that. Oh, door's open now.
Ah, the Indigo Violet Compact Power Generator. But it seems to be inoperable. Looks like it's missing a piece. Can you find it?
Joke's on you. I don't have a lurk command, so you have to stay. Hold shiffle. Oh, there you are. Oh, wait. I need the piece. Ooh. Spooky game. Hello, Snow. Welcome in. Yes, we're playing a spooky game today. We're playing Indigo Park. It's a new indie horror game. I gotta find that piece. Where are you? Oh, I see a cog. Is that it? There we go. Why do I hate you? I love you, Michi, and that's why I want you to stay. It builds tolerance. Tolerance to horror. That's exactly what you need. Ooh, a gator. Hey, buddy. You weren't there last time I was here, and neither was this tarp.
Okay, for real this time. Welcome to Indigo Park.
Ooh, so nice in here. Flashlight toggle. Okay. No flashlight battery, okay. And I'm sorry, it's happy to say that. Oh, well, it's okay. The best customer service out- the best horror out there really is customer service. Love dealing with people. No, I don't. That is my horror game. Just having casual conversations in groups you're not familiar with. I didn't know Hoshi was afraid of horror games. That is interesting.
Guest needs a critter cuff. That will allow you access to reserved areas, charge payments to your room, and wear a critter cuff. I think there's some in the gift shop. Head in there and I'll get you set up.
Okay, so this is basically just Disneyland. You can tell because there's Walt Disney right there holding his mascot. Ooh, gift shop. I can't wait to buy overpriced things that I don't need. What are these? Oh yes, I'm a baby, but that's the best part. Yeah, well, everyone loves to have a good person that can scream. Entertain them.
There you go, buddy. Your very own critter cuff. A new way to interact with the park that also doubles as a pedometer, heart monitor, and mood ring.
Data disclosure agreement included.
Gimme. Hey, now if I go missing, my parents can find me. Perfect.
Uh-oh, the door mysteriously locked. Why not test out your band and save the day? Hooray! Great work, buddy. Now try entering the park, and we can start our Indigo adventure.
Wait, holding his mascot's hand? Wait. Get back in that grave. That's totally not under Splash Mountain. Oh, well, hold on. Yeah. Ah, I think someone's gonna have to sue then. You know, I've been on Splash Mountain a bunch of times. Apparently they're tearing down that ride and making it into like a Princess and the Frog themed attraction. Because nobody remembers the movie it came from. And also they don't want to remember the movie it came from because it comes from Song of the South, which is a very racist Disney movie, which they try very hard to bury. So yeah, I can definitely understand why they're renaming that attraction. Wait. Ooh, concession stands. They had to put him somewhere when they upgraded Splash Mountain. Yeah. Which is... Oh, loading. Oh. Oh, wonderful. Men's washroom. What's in here? Can I take a whistle? No? No? No whistles? Okay. Alright, I'm gonna be bold. Ladies' washroom. Damn. Oh! There are figures in the ladies' washroom! So that's why they don't allow us in. Got it, got it. It's because they want to keep their anime figures to themselves. I saw a video of nobody going to greet Pinocchio's dad since nobody knew who he was. Oh! Oh, oh, that actually hurts me. Oh, that actually hurts me. Nobody remembers Geppetto.
Our test, buddy. Looks like the park is going through some renovations. For the inconvenience, your Rambly Tuesday discount will be 3% off. Why not celebrate this great deal with a ride on my railroad? To test your sleuthing skills, I'll let you find this one all by yourself.
Okay. Bear in the ladies' room, hey. I respect boundaries, but if you have anime figures in there, I'm sorry, I'm going in. That shit's expensive. Ooh, an old computer. Can I take it? No. I am a... Oh.
Official data suggests you may be a bit older than the target audience for this ride. It's one of my favorites. Do you know why Rambly the Raccoon loves Rambly's Railroad? Because I like trains.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense. Who doesn't love trains? The fuck was that bird? Why was there a fucking bird there? I saw feathers, I don't like that. Alright. I see you, bitch. Alright, I like trains too. Trains are nice. Okay, see, we're doing good. We're on the train! Unfortunately, I can't go on these anymore because I'm tall as shit and I'd break my neck. I kind of want to play this game now. Yeah, you can!
Rambly's Railroad. I'm Conductor Rambly.
The first... you okay, Rambly? You kind of glitching out there. The first game is free to download, actually. So you can download the first chapter right now for free.
Oh look, it's Molly McCaw!
It's Molly McCaw!
Oh.
Pilot you ever saw.
Oh, she's a girl.
Sure are, Mo. Why, you only crashed into 6 barns this week.
I'm not crashing, Rambly. I'm barnstorming.
Oh, she's bad with directions like me.
What's barnstorming?
It's crashing with style. It barely hurts at all.
We're not flying. We're falling with style.
Huh? Alright. Ride her attraction, alright? Say it, say less. We'll be fine. Alright, Rambly, so, what are we doing now? It's not bad.
Oh, Finley! Come on out and greet the people!
Hi, Rambly.
Oh, he's like a dragon thingy.
You've known me for 100 years, Rambly.
It's a sea dragon?
I'm always long, because I'm always longing for a new seashell for my collection.
Oh, Finley, you should come out of your shell.
How about you come into it instead?
My oh, wow, he's me for real, for real.
Oceanic Odyssey will teach you all about the wonders down under the deep blue
You should get out of your cave. No, you should come in mine. Jesus, man. I'm so lonely. Oh, Jesus. Do you need an antidepressant, bro? Okay. Gotta keep him on a watch. I don't think he's in the right state of mind. Oh. Y'all need to clean up in here. Huh? Wait, you glitching, bro? Get the ride back up and running. What's wrong with it? Oh, it's a skunk thing. Oh, okay. Alright, how do I fix this? I'ma fix you, Rambly, I'm coming. Holy shit. Holy shit. Okay, alright. Alright, alright. Hopefully the game isn't too loud, by the way. I gotta say that again. I gotta go, need to fix the rest of dinner. Hey, no problem. Have some good dinner. What are you eating? Tell me. What'd you cook? What were they cooking? Alright, alright. Ooh, a little hat. Where's the... Oh, there it is. Perfect. Alright. I swear to God, if something jumps out at me, I'm gonna fucking kill someone. Preferably an animatronic. Audio's perfect. Thank you. All right, cool. We're back up and running. I made cheesy potato, chicken, corn soup. Ooh, that sounds nice. Ooh, it sounds tasty. I recently got the Stardew Valley cookbook.
Hater Lloyd.
Oh, he
Do
hates
not
Lloyd.
Shame me with that common folk name. I am the proud, the prestigious, the professional Lloydford L. Lyon, actor extraordinaire!
Oh wow, he's so pissed.
Great act, Lloyd.
Of course it was!
Oh, well, we're speeding along, aren't we? I see he doesn't like Lloyd. But yeah, I recently got the Stardew Valley cookbook, and just a few days ago I made some tropical curry, and my parents really liked it. I'm surprised how good it tasted, honestly. Look left sometimes. Oh, okay, okay. I'll make sure to do that.
So, what do you think? Pretty fun, right? Now you know all about my friends and Lloyd.
And
so
Lloyd.
Where do you wanna go?
I was distracted. The animatronic thingies were right on my right, so I had to see everything. I want to see what they were showing me. Never mind, you missed. I missed something. Oh. Damn it. It's okay, I missed it too. Aw. Oh, this is beautiful. Wow. So this isn't under the park. This is actually this here. Everything's up and running above ground. Cool. I thought we were underground for a second. What's going on? So, Lloyd's main theater stage. Let's see what's there. Oh, okay. Well, seeing how it's the birds stage today, we'll most likely have to go there. So, this is pretty much like the hub world of the game. Alright. Yeah, I've been to Disneyland a lot of times. And honestly, it's okay. We have an amusement park here called Canada's Wonderland, and I've been to that. I haven't been to that one in years either.
Hey buddy, come over here.
I'm not really an amusement park kind of person.
This here's an information kiosk. If there's anything around the park you want to ask me about, just stop by here and I'll ramble on about it.
Okay. Ooh, okay. Collectibles. I've only been there once? Oh, okay. It's okay. Again, not really big on amusement parks, but it's alright. Wait. Why am I stuck? Let me... Huh. Weird.
Oh, I got this! I know the commercial by heart!
There it is.
Wow, it's the unlimited edition Rambly the Raccoon Raction figure. Push him down and he jumps. Push him up and he doesn't. Only $19.99 at your favorite toy store.
Wonderful. I think the only time I went to Disney after years was to see the Avatar attraction, because they were really promoting it, like the Avatar Pandora thing. That was fun. The line, though, hell no. I now remember why I hate amusement parks. That line, 2 hours to ride not even a 15-minute attraction, like a 2-minute attraction. Not my thing, but hey. The experience is nice, though. Though I'd love to go into an amusement park on Halloween. Because I think I've heard that that's where they give you like a shit ton of candy. And the Halloween parties there are pretty awesome. Like, again, over here in Canada, all we have is like Halloween Haunt or something like that. But unlike Disney, where it's just a Halloween party, Halloween Haunt, they actively try and scare you. And they follow you around in horror-themed makeup.
Look at that. You're at Jetstream Junction.
Not my thing.
Looks like Jetstream Junction's being tuned up. Last I checked, there's a security office in the back of the theater. Maybe a friendly wrangler can help you get in.
Oh, okay. Orange level access granted. Yay! We have to go to Lloyd's main stage. Cool, cool, cool. Alright. Not bad. The game doesn't look bad at all, actually. I do like how unique this is compared to other, like, mascot horror games. Like, I do like how open it is. Alright, Lord, let me in. Ooh, ooh. Oh, I can't pick that up. Aww. Hey, Lloyd! Yeah, they did their own thing. I like it. They put a nice spin on it. Oh, what's wrong? Huh? I thought that was supposed to be an animatronic. I'm so used to Five Nights at Freddy's. Is it a guy in a suit? Is it just some guy in a fursuit? Hey, man, I'm not gonna be like the...
Oh. I've got eyes all over the park, but... can't see anything behind the stage. If you're going back there, be careful. Your Critikov is not yet able to resuscitate you.
What? What do you mean resuscitate me? The fuck you mean resuscitate? Okay. Alright. Huh? Hi, buddy. Hi, friend. Hell, you're on your own, buddy. The hell you mean by that? Oh, fuck you, big. Oh, fuck you, big. Oh, boy. Boy, I'd love to go the opposite direction right now. It's a guy in a fursuit. You guys know Tony the Tiger was a VTuber at one point? This story, I think, is pretty well known among the community. But yeah, Tony the Tiger was a VTuber for, like, I think maybe
a few weeks before, like, all the furries, like, bump. Oh, what the fuck?
Why is this bird stalking me? I need a restraining order. Like I was saying, Tony the Tiger's VTuber account was bombarded with furries, and that's why he immediately had to stop VTubing, because it was making the guy really uncomfortable, because he had no idea what was happening. He wasn't a furry, so this was just like a job for him. So it was like, why is everyone trying to come on to me? I'm just a serial mascot.
Oh, fuck!
Oh. Oh, you fucking dumbass! Ah, you fucking idiot. Yeah, boxes. Yeah, eat boxes.
Yeah, it was weird. Imagine you're just doing your job and then you get a whole bunch of weird fetish people trying to come after you. I will say this once and I will say this again. If you're a furry, you're okay on my channel. I do not discriminate. I just have to make fun. You gotta admit, your community does some weird ass shit sometimes. That's me and Kodiak. I'm not. I'm being... Yeah. Well, he was being a dumbass. He got crippled from boxes. I'm seeing this giant ass tiger coming after me. Okay, I can leave now. Big ass tiger, looks like he lifts weights, gets knocked out by boxes. Why do I hear shit? Why do I hear like he's coming? Oh no, he heard me talking that shit. Oh no, I don't like this. Oh, I don't like this. Oh, it sounds like he's coming. Oh, Bowser is coming, yay! Don't touch me. Heard you talking smack? Yeah, he did. Please don't touch me. Hey. You ain't gonna come after me, right? We're friends. We're friends, right? Fuck. Oh, fuck. Ah, shit. Ah, shit. Ah, shit. Ah, shit. Oh, yeah. Oh, fuck. What? Oh, it's the ringing. Oh, he doesn't like the ringing. Ah, okay, so he doesn't like the sound. Got it. That'll keep me safe. I think. I think. Okay. Alright. Can I leave now? Can I leap? Let me leave. Yeah. Take that, Tony the Tiger. Now, I don't like that bird was looking at me very seductively. Yeah, she was looking at me very seductively. She was giving me the fuck me eyes. No. She was looking at me like I fucking did her wrong. I didn't like that. I don't like it. That bird was looking at my ass. I think my game glitched here. It was pitch black for me. Oh, no fair. Either that or you forgot to turn your flashlight on. That's also an option. Is this mold or is this... Is it mold or is it pistachio? You tell me. Damn. That sounds like a skill issue or maybe you just forgot to turn your flashlight on. Which, speaking of, I'm glad you don't have to actually charge this thing. That would have been a pain in my ass. I could have forgot, maybe. Because my flashlight did turn off automatically. Until I pressed the button. I like how that clock is just constantly spinning. Can I... There you go. Alright. Jetstream Junction. I made the game scary for myself. Yeah, you were playing on challenge mode.
Say, why don't you check out Molly's rooftop races? It's not far from here, and it's a great warm-up before we get into the bigger rides. Just take it up at Molly's landing pad.
God, I know I'm not supposed to pay too much attention to it, but the animation really just grips my attention like a moth to a flame. Ah. All right. So, like, what's everyone's favorite, like amusement park ride? Mine is Space Mountain. I used to hate that ride so much, and the only reason I rode on it with my dad was because, like, I was promised a video game if I went on the ride with him. And I closed my eyes the entire time because I did not want to see what was happening. But yeah, after that, I got, like, really used to Space Mountain. I don't even know if that ride is still around anymore, because, like, I think they may have replaced it with Guardians of the Galaxy or something. Either that or that's Epcot. Again, I have not visited these attractions in a very long time. He's like the fruit video for kids with ADHD. The fruit video? All I can think about, like, he reminds me more of, like, Toucan Sam. Like a very sassy Toucan Sam. Alright, alright. Alright, get me the hell out of here. What the? Oh, there it is. I don't like this place. Ooh, an arcade. Alright. Have you not seen it? It's just a bunch of fruit dancing that people watch. No. It's just a bunch of fruit dancing that people- Oh no. Oh no, Molly's plane crashed. Okay. Oh, okay. Alright. Oh. It's a video game. Oh shit! Yeah! Oh. Oh. Molly's plane crashed. Somewhere in Ramble, Woods. Woods, yes, I better find her quickly and make sure she's okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I've seen too much brain rot. You really have. I'm annoyed by that. Too much TikTok rots your brain. I can't be on TikTok for too long because I actually will feel my brain cells actively die. All the fucking. I'm not good at platformers. I'm figuring this out. Okay. This time for sure. If I miss the berry, I miss the berry. If I miss the berry, I miss the berry. Yeah. It's like Mario. Yeah. One HP in a dream. Nope. Oh, I can double jump. Nice. Don't die. Nice. Why are you in love for? I want to kill you. How dare you have feelings and affection? Oh shit. Where's my friend? If animatronics are stalking me right now, I'm very grateful they let me game. Watching as I just try and get the high score. Alright. Oh! Molly, what happened? Hey, Rambly. I was flying through the woods, but suddenly, I couldn't see a thing. Oh, it's the skunk. Salem, looks like my smokescreen made her crash right on by. Salem! I should have known you were behind this, you shady skunk. Let her go. Nah. How's about I try a new potion on her instead? I'm tired of wasting it on squirrels. Molly, look out! Oh, she's evil. Too slow, dumpster face. But what did you do to her? Meet the new and improved Molly McCaw.
Now with one of that... None of that friendship garbage stopping her from tearing you to pieces. I wonder what she really thinks of you now. Have fun finding out! Oh no. Oh. Yeah. Got her. Oh, it's a boss fight. Oh. Ow. Okay, thanks. Thank you for that. What the hell? Ooh. I got a berry. I don't think this was staring at me before. Unless it was. Alright. Apparently Salem is a girl. You know, I kind of looked at the design and I thought that, so... Eh. But with a name like Salem, you would think boy. All I can imagine is Salem the cat from Sabrina the Teenage Witch. Alright, where is... Oh, I think I gotta go here. Wait, that's outside. Molly's launching pad, there. All right, such a good show Sabrina was. Wait, where the freak? All right, fine. I gotta go up the stairs, maybe. Let's try that again. Maybe I went the wrong way. All right. Yeah, Sabrina was a fun show. I loved it. Am I missing something? Nope, there's no door here. Anyways, back to lurking. Enjoy your lurk, Michi. We appreciate Sabrina the Teenage Witch here. Though that new one they made is kind of weird. The one that was connected to the Riverdale show. But then again, Riverdale is also weird, so like... Yeah. Oh, there we go. Race Top Races. Oh, you read the books from the show too. Oh, I didn't know there were books based on it. I know there were comic books. It was based off a comic. What is over here? A collectible. A poodle. I was not a fan of the new one either. Yeah, I watched like 2 seasons of it, and then I was like, yeah, this is kind of dumb. I don't know if you guys are like this, but like sometimes I'll watch like entire series recaps of shows I stopped watching just to see what happens afterwards. That show got really, really weird. Like really weird, and the plot stopped making sense.
To the right again. Don't worry though, your pal Rambly has the repairman on speed dial.
Yeah, Michi really was meant to be a librarian. It fits her lore.
We're sorry. The number you have dialed has been disconnected or is no longer in service. Please check the number and dial again.
Say, why don't you check out Molly's landing pad? It's not far from here, and it's a great cooldown after that exhilarating ride. Just take a down from Molly's rooftop races.
It's not a scary part, Michi. The raccoon was just telling us where to go. Yeah. But yeah, that show got really weird. It's like when you know the show is going to be a train wreck and you stop, you're just curious to see how far it went. And then you realize, oh wow, they really didn't know what they were doing and it just got significantly worse. It just became a never-ending train wreck until it just jumped the shark. Harvey did deserve better. I will say I did like his actor. His actor was really nice. His actor did the part really well. There we go, new section! Yay! It's the ball pit! It's the pink eye machine! If you go into these things, you're guaranteed two things. A cold and pink eye. Ah, the ball pit. Gotta love the ball pit. What is this? Oh, it's a puzzle. Yeah. Oh god, I'm bad at puzzles. It's nice music, though. Did you ever watch any shows that you didn't realize was weird until you got older? Ah. That's a good question. Zatch Bell. I'm gonna say Zatch Bell. Zatch Bell was a weird show growing up. Wee! Oh, okay. It was one of those shows I forgot about, and then I watched the, I read the wiki of what happened, and all the plot points made absolutely no sense, and I just was like, oh my god, this was it. Like, all the mysteries were so dumb, and the plot itself was kind of weird. Alright, so this is a puzzle. And then I can open the door. Yeah, some anime just was just like, yeah, this is cool, and then you get older, and then you're just like, what is this? What was I watching? Me, my strawberry eggs. I've never heard of that one. Alright. One for me was Life with the Canadian show. Their relationship seemed weird as siblings. Yeah. Alright. So this is a puzzle. Let's play. Good, when I was older I realized that it was terrible. You know, the funny thing is, the actors knew the shipping. They knew people were shipping the step siblings together, and they actually leaned into it too, which is probably why you all felt very uncomfortable by it. It got even to the point where the actors were in on it as well. And I think even like years later, they took a photo of Derek and the main girl together. As kind of like a nod to the shipping. Like, they're not together or anything like that, but they acknowledge that there was a ship. So, yeah. Very, very weird. Digging deeper and learn the actors need to read out the fanfic. Oh, wow. Honestly, based. If you have the fandom, lean into it. I mean, hell, that's gonna keep your show alive. Do it. I'm trapped in here. Okay, great. I gotta figure out this puzzle. Figure out the puzzle. Okay. Huh. I have to figure this out. All right. You gotta use your brain, Kodiak. Yeah, I do. Okay, so star? Star there. Right? Yeah! I use brain! I use my brain! Star, got it! Alright. Hello? Oh, birdie! Birdie! Hi, birdie! Oh. Oh. Ohayou gozaimasu! Me, My Strawberry Eggs was an anime about a male teacher. Pretending to be female to teach an all-girls school and his students having a crush on him. A crush on him as a girl? Interesting plots. Interesting. Oh, shit. I'm sure it was a lot of people's bisexual awakening. Oh, fuck. So we... Alright. Hi, bird. Hi, big bird. Ooh, this is nice. This is nice. There you go. Okay. Alright. As a kid, I didn't catch all that. Yeah, well. One man's trash is another man's treasure, as they say. Anyway, time to go. Oh, so the scary thing came on, so you're afraid now, huh? Okay. Can I go up here now? Because the bird's here. Make a mental note here. Alright. Alright. Making a mental note. I'm seeing my surroundings. Got it. Alright. This should be fun. The door isn't opening. Fantastic. Well then. Well, back in the ball pit I go. Wait, Kodiak. Oh. I see the... and there's a care package. I believe you can figure out what you need to do.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jojo. Thank you. Alright, alright. Back in hell I go. Alright. Okay, there's okay. No, I don't want to quit. I just want to know. Back up I go. I swear to God, that bird better not show up. Don't show up. Don't show up. I swear to God, don't show up. Don't fucking show up, Big Bird. God, this is like that one puzzle from Security Breach. Oh, wait. Oh, mental note. Yellow circle. Yellow circle. Got it. Yellow circle. Okay, yellow circle. I'm smart. I'm figuring it out. Yellow is circle. All right. Oh, I have to go back in there. Okay, so yellow circle, so I need to pay more attention. The thing isn't gonna come jumping at me, is he? Okay, cool. Mental note, mental note, mental notes. Alright. Alright, nothing here. Alright. Up. Crawling up these things as a kid is a pain in the ass, especially in the summertime where you walk in these things and you feel like you're burning alive. I don't know why we did that kind of stuff as a kid. And then the static would get you too, and then you just like feel like you're static shock. Everything you touch is gonna hurt you. You know it is. Okay. All right. Well, I know yellow is circle. So that's nice. Alright. Blue raccoon. No, that's not it. Okay, so that's that. I'm just gonna see if I can cheese it. Nope. Okay, cool. I gotta make sure. I actually have to pay attention. I'm going in here one more time. Maybe, oh yeah, pay attention to your surroundings, yeah. Nope, okay, that's where I was. Alright. Shake my head, you're trying to cheat. Yes, I was trying to cheat, actually. I'm paying attention. I am a cheater at puzzle games. Green could be... Wait, this is green, so green could be square. Oh, there's another part of this. Oh, I'm stupid. I didn't realize that. Oh, I'm dumb. Red star. Okay. Red star. Yeah. All right. We're doing good. God. Honestly, parks as a kid were pretty much like the worst place to be if you were a child, because they were the most likely to cause like long-lasting damage. Like the, not the seesaw, but like that swinging ride, like the horse that would be on that giant like metal like string. Not string, but like a coil. That shit, if that shit hit you, goddamn, that shit hurt like a bitch. The rocking horse, that thing. Okay, green diamond. No, that's not a diamond, that's a triangle. God, I failed shapes. I can't believe I failed kindergarten. Okay, red star, green I almost said diamond again. Green triangle. Yeah. Isosceles, got it. All right. I think I just played the video games instead of going to the playroom. Oh yeah, the video games, yes. Oh, if you had like that bougie McDonald's that had like the GameCube in there. Okay, so two stars, blue star, red star, green, isosceles triangle. Oh my God, bird. Hey girl. Hey, yeah, you might not doing that. Aw, man, like, you knew you were in a bougie neighborhood if your McDonald's had, like, a GameCube attached to it. Or, like, an N64. If you had that, you were living the high life. Alright. So, it's... I was right with this one. Star. Oh, shit, I missed it. Go back. Yeah, big bird's on my ass. Okay, cool. Green diamond. Blue diamond. Blue star. Yeah, I've been to a couple of those places where, like, they had the built-in... The fuck was that? Where they had the nice GameCubes attached to it, and they had, like, the tech demos or Mario 64. Oh. The older generations will never understand how it feels to walk into a store and see like the kiosk with the game console attached to it that you could just play while your parents did their grocery shopping or just went shopping in general. What the fuck? Blue Diamond got Steven Universe on the brain. Yeah. Apparently they're thinking of bringing it back with all the reboots that they've been making for Cartoon Network. Yeah, they're thinking of it. I don't have the thing. Okay, got it. I wouldn't mind Steven Universe coming back as long as they, like, didn't do what they did with Future. Because I wasn't a fan of Future. It was pro. Hi.
Ho.
Fuck. Ow. Okay. I thought I had time to turn around. No, I didn't. You were caught by Molly McCaw. Wow. Okay. Molly can repeat words that she's heard. Don't be fooled. Press E to respawn. That was fun. Well then. All right, Big Bird, round two. All right. Round two, Big Bird. Nope. Open, 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 open.
This way, this way, this way, this way.
Nah, nah. I don't want to play with you. Shit, 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 shit. Nope, nope. Nope. Let me leave. Let me leave. Freak. I'm guessing this was the puzzle you had issues with. Bird, bird, leave me alone. Oh, fuck. Help. Oh, oh, yeah, let's go. Fuck yeah. Freedom, freedom. Freedom, freedom, freedom. Hoy, freedom, freedom, freedom. Freedom, freedom, freedom. Oh, I could hear her. Oh, I could hear her. The hell out of here.
Wait, hold on. This one's staff only.
Shut up. Let me in. Let me in. Oh, fuck. Bird. Oh. 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 Okay. Okay. Oh, there was someone in the suit.
Welcome to the Rambly's Wranglers Registered Grill. Here we have plenty of amenities and... okay. Okay. I can see in your facial tracking that you're scared. You're angry. Upset. Transparency is an important part of our policy here at Indigo Park, so I need to be honest about something.
Yeah?
The park has been inactive for years. Employees stop showing up, guests too, the mascots are... I just was so excited to see a visitor, and I wanted to be sure you were given the best experience possible. But I was confined to the entrance for so long, I didn't realize just how much disrepair the park is...
Oh, Leafy, is that the puzzle that you couldn't do? I'm sorry.
Sorry for the inconvenience.
I'm sorry, I'm a little better.
But I have an idea. I have access to the repair documentation in my database. I just can't execute most tasks without authorization from a human user. You must have come here because the park matters to you too, right? Would you be willing to help me restore the park?
I winged it. I'm not even gonna lie. I winged it.
Tracking data that you aren't opposed to this. Ooh, I'm so excited. Let's get this place back in business.
I just fucking ran. That's what I did. Huh. Well, either people are in that suit or some shit's happening. Well, on the bright side, I eventually got it. I'm glad
okay.
You got it.
Welcome to the crew, Rookie Wrangler Registered. Your first official job as one of Rambly's Wranglers Registered is to get out of the Rambly's Wranglers Registered room. Head left towards the Rookie Wrangler Register security room to set yourself free. Phew, kind of exhausting to say that whole spiel. But Rambly's Wranglers Register is a registered trademark. That expired yesterday.
Ah. Yeah, I actually thought I was going to get lost in that puzzle too. I thought she was going to get me again. Thankfully not. Thankfully. It was actually pretty confusing though at first. I didn't know what the hell I was doing. What's here? Oh. Loading screen? Alright. What's this? Security cameras. Hmm. So I'm guessing this is all Salem's fault in some shape, way, or form. Salem did some scary shit, and now we're stuck here. In this situation. Now, Tony the Tiger was gunning for my ass not too long ago, so I'm guessing he's my next target. Are we outside? Am I supposed to be outside? I guess. Let's see. Let me see what to do. Oh.
Hey, buddy. Did you dig that out of the lost and found? Or was it in the trash? No surprise a guest in our park would dispose of a non-Indigo brand toy. I suppose he'd make playtime special for a child with poor taste, though.
Oh, well. This is honest. Can I get out of here? Thank you. No? Okay, fine. Alright, we're doing okay so far. Ooh, oceanic. This is where the sea dragon with depression is, right? Oceanic Odyssey.
Wow, you made it to Oceanic Odyssey! You're doing a great job, Rookie Wrangler!
Are you the final boss, raccoon thing?
You'll find a potpourri of porpoises, pickerels, and perches as far as the eye can see. But please don't tap the glass. Never really know what.
Let me in. Don't tap the glass. Got it.
Hey, buddy. You okay?
Huh?
You look kind of tired. Do you need a moment? Don't worry, it's fine. I don't blame you for taking a rest after all that.
Hey, oh.
I could go for a nice, relaxing defragmentation myself. But before you settle down, you up for a little survey to help us improve the park?
Thanks for visiting Indigo Park. Hope all your dreams came true.
Did we make it to the end?
Got some time and you're up for a lark. Stick around for the Rambly review. I'm here to offer my best.
Oh, you missed Finley.
Guest I assist. And lots of happy feet.
Damn, I missed Finley.
I get to exist.
Let's try it.
Were you satisfied with the rides?
Yes or no?
Were you satisfied with your guide?
I sure hope so.
Do you plan to come back?
Will Am I at the end of the demo?
Your experience convince you to tell friend about us. Did I earn your trust? At Indigo Park, there is a stark contrast to everything I know this place.
Oh, we beat it.
Be, but out of the dark, you've given a spark of sunshine to this kingdom's faithful devotee.
Oh, wow.
Indigo Park.
I wasn't expecting to beat the game that fast. I was expecting like another hour.
Even I don't know what we might find, but fight through the dark and I'll be your spark of sunshine to get you out of any bind. That is, if you want to keep going.
Oh, idea!
I know all of this isn't fair to you. It's an awful lot to ask. But here comes Rambly Review Part 2 to sell you on our task. I'm here to view and assess.
Not a bad song.
Valuable guest as I learn. And lots of happy feedback ensures you're gonna return. Right, I'm so happy you rode a ride.
Good job, and yeah, the creator is, the creator's this was mostly a pilot. Chapter 2 will be longer. Okay. Okay. That makes sense.
Indigo Park, there is a stark contrast to everything I know.
Oh, I could already tell this is gonna get very popular on the internet. This is gonna be very popular among kids. I could already tell. There's gonna be a lot of fan art of this. I could already see it happening. I wonder if he's gonna be like Scott Cawthorn and make the game like in 2 months. Like the entire series is done by the end of the year.
Till all my old friends are united again, and I won't feel so left behind.
What are my thoughts?
Okay.
It's pretty good.
See you next time, buddy. Please.
Is that it? Overall, my thoughts of the game are it's pretty good. I'm interested in it. I like what they're doing with it. Though this was like just a test of what's to come, so I hope they do more with it. I hope they expand on what they have here so far. I think it's a lot of fun. I'd be down playing for future chapters of the game if anyone wants to watch me stream it. But yeah, for sure. Overall, I enjoy it. Indigo Park is a full-on passion project that we've been working on for a little over a year now. The stories and world that we want to create with Rambly and his friends are very special to us, but with the scale of this game, we're going to need some help. If you enjoyed your experience with Chapter 1, consider supporting our socials if you want to see Chapter 2. No matter what happens, we hope you enjoyed your stay. Thanks for visiting Indigo Park. Alright. Main menu. Get me out of the game. Get me out of the game. Hold on. I don't know how to get out of here. Oh well. We'll figure it out. I have to plug up my controller. You're stuck here forever. Forever and ever. Oh, well, no, we're not. Like hell, we're not. Come on. Yeah, we're probably stuck. Also, I can show you what Finley looked like since you missed him. Oh, okay, yeah, sure. Yeah, feel free to show me. Oh yeah, we're definitely stuck here. So I'll probably just close the game. I'll probably just close the game now. Yeah. Alright. Interesting. Alright, so I have no idea if we should no more scary? Yeah, no more scary. We beat the game! Awesome! I'm curious though, since we've only been here for an hour, I don't know if we should like end it here or if we should do something else. Let me see. Oh, that's what Finley looks like. Oh, thank you, Leifu. I will show the chat. I will show the chat. More? Okay, well. Let's see, add, not a browser, not that, image, yes. Yeah, that's what Finny looks like. Yeah. Sent it to you, if you looked at the tank at the end, it swims past. Oh, so we totally missed this. Yeah, we totally missed this guy. Ah. Oh, cool. Well, okay. Yeah. Alright. So, let's figure out what we can do. I'm going to end this recording, and then I'm going to start a new recording. The stream's still going to be on. I'm just going to stop it for the YouTube side of things. So, yeah, if you're on YouTube, thank you for watching the first episode. Hopefully, you'll be returning for future episodes once they release them. I'd be happy to play this game more in the future. But until then, take care and goodbye, YouTube. And